Hello there, welcome to this video. We'll see in this video all the most important features inside Camtasia Studio 9. Leave comments in the video description to improve our future videos about this software. In the previous beginner video tutorial, we saw the very basic features for Camtasia 9, but this software allows you to add annotations, transitions, animations, and effects on your clips. You can find all these features on the far left, under the Media tab. Let's check them. The annotations are used to add extra clips on your project, such as text, callouts, geometrical shapes and effects, all grouped on top. Use callouts to add simple text or callouts, which are simple pieces of text over a nice colored shape. To add one, just drag and drop it on your project timeline. This will be represented as a text or callout clip that can be moved and stretched as seen for the other clips. Let's see how to edit and manage this. By default, the text shows ABC. You can type in by double-clicking on the text directly on the preview. Then click outside the text box to apply. You can edit the text box as you like. Click and drag it to move the text where you like. Use the notes on the text box to scale it. The text will be sized in order to get fully contained. In case you have the crop tool enabled above, only the text within the box will be shown. To rotate text, just hover on the second central circle that will turn to a green color and click and drag. On the right, you can use the Properties panel to regulate the object properties. Under Visual Properties, regulate scale, opacity, rotation, and placement in a precise way. And under Text Properties, regulate the font family, color, size, style, and paragraph for your piece of text. If you import a callout, you will also have the annotation properties where you can change the annotation shape, its filling color, outline, thickness, and opacity. When working with text and callouts, remember to place these on a track that stays on a higher position from the top, or you will get these overlapped by other clips. You can use arrows and lines and shapes to add arrows and geometrical shapes that do not contain any text. You can adjust their placement, scaling, rotation, and appearance properties by using the visual and the annotation properties seen for the callouts. Then you have the blur and highlight, or special section. These are special effects used to point at, highlight, or apply blur on specific parts of your video preview. When you import them on your project, these create an effect clip that affects all the clips that are listed right under it. Also, through the video preview, you can see that the effect applies within the box you see. You can move, scale, and rotate by editing the box or using the visual properties, as seen for the previous sections. Under Annotation Properties, you can regulate this effect, and furthermore, invert the affected region. Sketch Motion is used to add an animated callout in order to highlight the point it is placed. This works just like the callouts, with the difference that these do not contain any text. You also have the Transition section. This is used to add transitions to your visible clips in order to make them appear and disappear in a cool way. Choose one and drag and drop it on the beginning or on the ending part of the visible clip. The transition applied is shown as a green area on the clip and can be adjusted in time length by stretching the edges of its area. Whereas if you want to change the kind of transition, just drag and drop another transition on the green area. To delete a transition, just right-click on it and go to Delete. Now let's see how to apply cool effects on your clips by using the behaviors, the audio, the visual effects, and the animations. Behaviors are special visual effects complete with an in-transition to make the clip appear, a cool during motion that makes the clip move, and then an out transition to make the clip disappear. Hover on one behavior to check it out, and click and drag it on a visible clip to apply it. On the Properties panel, The clip will now show the Behaviors Properties tab used to regulate the behavior in-out transitions and the motion effects under the During tab. Consider that, even if you stretch the clip and change its length and time, the behavior will adapt to it. To remove this behavior, just click on the cross in the top right corner under Behavior Properties. You can use audio effects to add cool effects to your audio and video clips with sounds, or visual effects to change or adjust the appearance of your picture and videos. As seen for the behaviors, it is sufficient to drag and drop them on the clips to apply them. All visual effects are listed under Visual Properties, and the audio effects under Audio Properties. Here, you can change and edit the way the effect must be applied. Also, next to the effect name, use the Reset button to reset all effect settings or the cross button to remove the effect. On your visible clips, you can also apply amazing effects called annotations, used to apply animated zoom and motion on the clip. With zoom and pan, place the playhead in a determined instant of time on the clip, and then scale and move the rectangle. This creates a cool motion where the zoom on the clip changes in time until reaching the values you specified by modifying the rectangle. This effect is represented by a small green arrow on the clip that indicates the duration of the dynamic zoom through its length and where the final zoom and pan are reached through its final white point. You can click and drag from the final point to regulate the duration of the zoom, and click on such point to change back its zoom and focus more on top. If you go to Animations on top, you can drag and drop an effect from the list. This will add another arrow as seen for the zoom and pan. You can apply multiple animations on the same clip. Just keep in mind that if you place new animations at earlier positions, you may change the behavior of all the following animations. To remove an animation, just right-click on its arrow and go to Delete. Animations can fully customize how to zoom and manage your clip in time. For example, if you place your playhead in between an arrow and you change any of the clip properties, you will split the arrow in two and make an overall animation that will include the clip properties defined in between. Camtasia also has several tools for your recordings. For example, you can add cursor effects to add effects to both left and right clicks. These work just when applied on recordings made under a .trek format. Also, use voice narration to add a quick voiceover on your recordings. There are other options inside More. You can use captions to add subtitles to your videos, or use interactivity to add quizzes. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more amazing and free video guides.